is that.
Well, let's come to the crux of the matter.
Right.
How can we develop our spirits to hear from God?
Okay. Let's read Hebrews 5.
So Hebrews 5, 13 and 14.
Right.
For everyone that you said milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness.
Right.
For he is a babe.
Right.
But strong meats belongeth to them that are full of age.
Right.
Even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil.
Right. And so it's not talking about the natural senses. It's talking about the senses of the spirit. And how do you mature in the things of the spirit or in hearing God's voice? By usage, by using them. You know, according to Hebrews, it says that through usage, that is how it's just like, you know, going to the gym to have some six packs. You should do it often and often. And that's why I said, when you start hearing God, you know, through whichever channel, you make certain mistakes, but the consistency should be there. So basically, that is a spiritual exercise. We should exercise our spirit through fasting. That's one, because at the end of the day, you want your spirit to be sensitive. We don't fast for forgiveness of sins and for many other things. When I fast at this stage of my life, I fast most, especially if I go for programs, so that I'll be very, very sensitive
to the
Holy Spirit. And then again, as we read earlier on, the voice of His Word, studying His Word, because see, you realize that God speaks His Word. I wrote that in Jesus is Coming. So when He speaks to you, if you're very familiar with Scripture, you realize that He's speaking His Word. And sometimes He will remind you of certain scriptures. You remember, here it says that, here it says that. And so one of the ways to sharpen your hearing is, and it's not just studying, but meditating on the Word, you know. And so fasting, through prayer, I'm sharing these, they are scriptural and they are also things that I've used over the years.
Okay.
Another way is praying in tongues. Praying in the Spirit sharpens your spirit, man. You know, amazingly, it sharpens your spirit, man, so much. But it gets to a point where no matter how full your belly is, because you've heard God so much that you are used to hearing Him, and He enjoys to speak to us. He enjoys to have a conversation, you know. And so sometimes develop that attitude of inviting God for a chat and for conversation when you're driving alone or when you're taking a walk and all that, you know. Yes.
I guess then you have to pay attention to.
Oh, yes.